आकांक्षा एंड आई एम हियर टू डील विद ऑल योर हेल्थ प्रॉब्लम्स, ऑल योर प्रेगनेंसी इश्यूज एंड ऑल योर क्वेरीज रिलेटेड टू वुमेन्स हेल्थ. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अ टॉपिक व्हिच इज वेरी कॉमन क्वेश्चंस ऑफ वेरियस कपल्स हु आर सफरिंग फ्रॉम पीसीओएस, दैट इज हाउ टू कंसीव इफ यू आर डायग्नोस्ड विद अ पीसीओएस. सो फर्स्ट लेट्स सी व्हाट इज पीसीओ. पीसीओ इज पॉलीसिस्टिक ओवरी, मींस मल्टीपल सिस्ट आर फॉर्मिंग इन द ओवरी. Normally what happens that when our menses starts, there are small follicles which ultimately grow and matures, and after growing and maturing, they get rupture into ova. But in PCO patient, what happens that these follicles do not grow and ultimately they take the form of cyst and they are present all around the ovaries. So these patients do not ovulate, and obviously if they do not ovulate, they have problem in conceiving and they have problem in menstrual cycle. I mean they have delayed menses. Their menses comes in every 1.5, 2, or 3 months. So main reason for delayed conception and delayed menses in PCO patient is that they are not ovulating properly. And the S component of PCOS means syndrome. This means that PCOS is not just a disease, it's basically a metabolic syndrome, which is affecting the whole body, not only the ovary. The problem in PCOS patient is that our body is becoming resistant to insulin, and insulin is a very important hormone to control the glucose metabolism. And there are various other hormonal imbalance also, which leads to increase in androgen hormone, which is basically a male hormone. And due to insulin resistance, increased sugar, increased androgen, obesity is also increases. I mean, you will put on a lot of weight, and particularly on the trunk area, on the tummy area. And because of all these hormonal imbalance, there are various other symptoms also, like you might have a lot of acne on your face, you might be suffering from hirsutism. Hirsutism is excessive facial hair. So it's very important to control this whole metabolic syndrome, to control this whole metabolic disorder, to conceive on time. So since we have seen that the whole game is of increased sugar and increased insulin, the most important factor whenever you are planning a pregnancy with PCOS is to have high protein diet and low carb diet. You have to reduce your carbohydrate and various other sugary and junk food, and you have to focus on the protein diet. If you are vegetarian, you can have lentils, soya, nuts, paneer, and if you're non-vegetarian, you can eat egg or fish on the daily basis. You also have to increase your diet, which is rich in various micronutrients and antioxidants, and for that you will have to take various green leafy vegetables, various fruits, fatty fishes if you can have, because they are rich in omega 3 fatty acids, and various dry fruits, because when your diet is rich in micronutrients and antioxidants, it will be healthy for your ovarian function. Second most important thing whenever you are planning with PCOS is to reduce your weight and bring your BMI in the normal range. For that, you have to start exercising. You can do whatever you like gymming, cycling, yoga, swimming, whatever you like, you can do it. And one good thing about PCOS is that even if you reduce your weight by 5 to 10%, chances of conception drastically increases. So just start exercising and reduce your weight at least 5 to 10%, and you will see the dramatic result. See, with dietary changes and exercise, almost 50 to 60% patients, couple generally conceive within 6 months to 1 year. But supposedly you are not able to conceive even after these, then you need ovulation induction drug. These drugs are given to promote ovulation. As we have seen that in PCOS patient, ovulation is not occurring properly. So you need various medicines so that your ovulation may occur. Generally 60 to 70% couples conceive with these ovulation drugs. Whenever we are using these ovulation drugs, we can try two methods. Either we can promote your ovulation, we can help you in getting ovulated with these drugs and let you try naturally. You'll be doing your sexual activity and you'll be trying for conception naturally. Second thing we can do is IUI, that is the we'll be promoting your ovulation, and whenever the ova is about to release, doctor usually injects husband's semen directly into the uterine cavity of the woman. So in these cases, the chances of conception increase. Next 60 to 70% of the patient generally conceive with these ovulation induction drugs. If you do not conceive with the ovulation induction and dietary and exercise activity, then we can go for laparoscopic ovarian drilling. In this, what we do is we make hole of 5 mm on your abdomen, two holes of 5 mm on your abdomen, and through that hole we put endoscope, and we just puncture the cyst present on the ovary. And after these cysts are punctured, the ovaries usually become responsive to the hormones and you are able to conceive. So after this ovarian drilling, almost 80 to 85% of the couples conceive within 6 months. Supposedly you are not able to conceive after laparoscopic drilling also, then definitely you need to go for IVF. But there is nothing to worry because the success rate of IVF in PCO patient is high. So be stress-free and plan your pregnancy properly with all these methods. If you like this video, do like, share, and subscribe this channel. And if you have any query, if you have any doubt, or if you like this video, do message me in the comment box. You can also follow me on my Facebook page for various other posts and videos. So remain connected with me and wait for my next video. Till then, take care. Bye.